going back on stage.
Let me just say, I appreciate a congregation that can have fun. Amen. And that was still some good stuff, though. That song was perfect. They were perfect. That was just fun. This morning, I wanted to share something with you. You all know we're in the midst of this Crossing Over campaign. And some of you have already heard the words I'm going to share with you this morning, because a couple of you attended those coffees we had this week. But if you attended them the previous week, something neat happened last Sunday. Someone left the service last Sunday and contacted me. This individual's so passionate about seeing Cypress Creek Christian Church getting out of debt, moving into that next phase, crossing over, that this individual is going to match dollar for dollar every gift that is given to our Crossing Over campaign. Though let me add, this individual needs some money to match. And yet I want to say that, you know, that's just a beginning point. I mean, this church, as many of you know, has been in debt for 38 straight years, building lots of great buildings, doing a lot of good stuff. But it's time for us to cross over that river and to move into the new thing that God has in store for us. And I can't even begin to imagine the ministry we're going to be able to do, the lives we're going to be able to touch, the disciples we're going to be able to make because we are free of that debt, able to put more resources into programs, into people, into touching lives. And what's great about it all is at the end of the day, God not only is at work in that kind of mission and ministry, but God wants to use us. And yet God recognizes that we're still frail individuals. And so what God does is provides us a meal, provides us some food, some sustenance for that journey. Says, come and be filled so that I can send you out to do the good work. I've got you a mission, but I don't leave you alone. I prepare you. And so that's what we're about this day, coming and feasting, being prepared, ready to be sent out into doing the good work. I invite you now to prepare yourselves for this meal.
Sing a song about someone to love, that everybody needs love. Sometimes we tend to forget. Some of us accept it without question. Some of us feel like, you don't know me. You don't know what I've done. There's no way anybody could love me. But the exciting part is Jesus does love us. Even before we were here, he loved us. In fact, it was on a night that he should have been the most anxious person in the world, because he was going to a cross, a death that was not a pretty death at all. Not that death is pretty. But in that meal, before that meal, he says, you need to calm down. Don't be troubled. If you believe in God, then believe in me. And when you do, there's this message that I have for you. It was such a simple message, because he took a plain, simple loaf of bread, and after he blessed it, he broke it. And he gave it to them. And he said, eat. This is going to represent my body that's going to be given for you. Then later in the meal, he took his cup and he gave thanks for it. And then he passed it to them and he said, drink, each one of you. This represents the blood that I'll share, the blood that will make a new covenant. a covenant that is going to be poured out for forgiveness of all of your sins, past, present, and future. And he said, and you know what? Because I love you so much, I'm not going to even drink anymore until you join me in the kingdom so that we can share it together. It was for all of us. Wasn't for part of us. This table is open for all of us. So when you come, remember, you're not coming because of what you've done. You've come in because of what Christ has already done for you. He's that someone that loves us.
Oh, gracious, gracious Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this wonderful day. Thank you so much for all of these beautiful people that you've gathered here today to honor you, honor your son. Thank you for putting us here and helping us with our mission, your mission. Thank you for loving us so much. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for blessing this table. Thank you for blessing these offerings. Help us use them, Lord, so that we glorify you. Thank you for everything that you do for us. Thank you for this church. Thank you for the individual who called Pastor Froge and offered his generous gift. Thank you, Lord. Now we want to honor you and say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. righteousness. Oh God, how I need you.
I don't know how much I appreciate a congregation, or especially this group up here on the stage, that I can kind of say to them, I have this nutty idea. Do you think you can pull it off? And they did. I think I just sent an email and it happened. That's cool. I appreciate that gift. Here at Cypress Creek, we are about helping shape and form people in disciple. In the notion of being a disciple. And it's not really anything that we do, it's just something that God's doing, but God needs hands, God needs feet, God needs us to help in that work and that process. This day, if you desire to connect your life with Christ, to connect your life to this community of faith, know that we would be blessed. You can do so by either coming forward as we're singing our song of discipleship, or you can meet with one of our elders or pastoral staff immediately after the service. Now let us join our voices on this wonderful song.
Thank you.
Let me talk about some of those things that we can do. First of all, I want to lift up that in your bulletins this morning, there was a registration form for the regional assembly. We're the host congregation. There's going to probably be between 300, 400, maybe 500 people from other churches throughout the region, which is Texas and New Mexico, coming to our church at the end of October. I'm hoping we'll have 150 or 200 of our own folks that will be there. Now, in that registration, if you are helping in any way, or if you stayed for the workday a couple weeks ago that helped prepare the campus for that, you get half off. So you may want to take advantage of that. There's also meals with that. But we invite you, if you got questions out at the guest table out there, they can share a little bit of information about it. When you do fill out the registration forms, bring them back to the church with a check, and we will send them in all together. So try to get them in by next week if you can. This afternoon at 3 o'clock is a journey of hope. This is a conversation around how we respond to cancer. And so many people are touched by it. Personally, a family member, a friend, and it's just going to be an amazing program. We've brought in a lot of folks to be a part of the panel conversation. So that'll be at 3 o'clock over in the youth building. Is that right, youth building? Thank you. I want to lift up that Wednesday studies continue this week. June actually is going to be leading the study. I believe this Wednesday you can come at noon or at 6:30. If you come a little early at the noontime, bring a sack lunch, share in conversation, or you can come a little early for the 6:30 one, and there will be a simple snack dinner. There's children's programming, youth programming, there's dance classes, a lot going on Wednesday nights, so just be aware of that. Next Saturday is Creek Fest. Thousands of people on our campus. This is a good starting place for meeting those future disciples that are going to be coming here. We're doing the blessing of the animals and stuffed animals with that. So bring your pets, bring your stuffed bunny, do whatever, and just come and be a part of what will be an amazing day here at Cypress Creek next Saturday. Women's Retreat coming up in 2 weeks, October 10th through the 12th. And finally, with our Crossing Over campaign, hopefully you received a letter and a commitment card this past week. If you didn't, it'll probably get there on Monday or Tuesday of this coming week. Be prayerful for that. And with that, Pat Cooksey is doing a prayer vigil starting October 3rd, this Friday night, through Saturday. And if you would like to take a 30-minute time slot for that, see her. They're filling up, but I think she still has some more time slots. Wee hours of the morning. I invite you now to reach out, to take the hand of somebody close. What an amazing morning, God, made amazing by your love and your grace. You've been a part of all that we have been doing this day, and we pray that your gifts of love not only fill us, but it fills us to overflowing. So that we can be the people who not only claim a God who first loved us, but we're willing to put that kind of love first in all things so that our sisters and brothers around our community are touched by it. Now send us out, God, better prepared to be the people that you are calling us to be, for you truly have a mission for us. In the name of Christ we pray, amen.
All right. Let the church arise.